This is not clickbait. This is not BS. If you are patient enough and frankly smart enough to watch this video through till the end, and by the way, I know many of you are going to turn the video off, but please trust me, if you want to all but guarantee that you will become a millionaire in your lifetime, watch the rest of this video. Hello everybody, Silver Picker here, and welcome to the Silver Picker Squad. Now, today's video is extra important, because today what we're going to be talking about is the number one thing you can do that will all but guarantee you to become a millionaire. So what are we actually talking about today? Well, today we're going to be talking about the Roth IRA. Now, you may have heard this term before, but not been quite sure what it meant. Don't worry, I was in the same boat just a few years ago, and I'm going to elucidate this topic to the point where you're going to actually be able to take action on it. And listen, if you are about to turn this video off because the topic sounds boring or you think it's going to be over your head, please do yourself a favor and watch anyway. Even if you think this is the most boring thing in the world, watch anyway. I promise you that your future millionaire self will thank you. So before we get into the nitty-gritty of all of this, let's talk about what exactly an IRA is. Well, an IRA, or individual retirement account, is a special type of brokerage account that allows you to trade bonds and stocks and ETFs, mutual funds, even precious metals, and of course, much more. But you may be thinking to yourself, okay, so what? You can do that with any type of trading account, right? What's the difference? Well, the IRA has some special benefits that you will want to know about. IRAs differ in that they have special accounting rules associated with them that are allowed by the government in order to encourage and incentivize people to save for their retirements. There are two main types of IRAs that we're going to be discussing today, the traditional and the Roth, and they basically differ on how they're taxed. With a traditional IRA, you are making investments with what's called pre-tax money, and that means you're making investments with money that you've earned before it's been taxed. And that offers a benefit because it means that you walk away with actually more money in your pocket today than you would otherwise because you receive a tax benefit. The way that works is imagine you make $50,000 a year. Normally you'd be taxed at a rate for $50,000 a year. But if you contribute $6,000 to your traditional IRA, instead of being taxed at $50,000, they deduct your investment and you're only taxed at $44,000, meaning you end up having a smaller tax bill. That's great. However, the big danger is that when you retire all the way down the road, you're going to be hit with a massive, massive tax bill on not only your contributions, but everything that those contributions has earned you. Now, the Roth IRA is the opposite. It's done with what's called post-tax money, and it is absolutely incredible, and that's what we're going to focus on for the rest of this video. Post-tax money means the money that you've earned that's sitting in your bank account after you've already paid taxes, you can invest up to $6,000 every year into your Roth IRA, and any money that those investments generate from now until when you retire is absolutely tax-free. That's right, when you cash out on retirement day, you don't pay a single penny in taxes. That is unheard of, and that's what makes this so incredibly special. Now, if you're sitting there and scratching your head and still wondering how this all works, why is this such an insane deal, and how on earth is this gonna make me a millionaire? Well, don't worry, I'm gonna explain the basic underlying theory behind this. The simple thing that runs this entire mechanism is what's called compounding interest. And compounding interest basically means that not only do you earn money on your investment, but your profits earn money as well. And then your profits earn money, and your profits earn money, and so on and so forth until you retire. So let's put this into numbers to make it a little clearer. So imagine you invest $1,000 at the beginning of the year, and at the end of the year, you walk away with a 10% return, meaning you've earned $100. So you're left with $1,100 at the end of the year. If you were to invest that original $1,000 again, and you'd earn 10%, you'd continue to make $100 per year. However, if you invest the profit as well, so you invest that $1,100 in year two, at the end of the year, if you have a 10% return, you're not gonna end the year with $1,200, but you're gonna end the year with $1,210, meaning you've basically earned 10% on your original principal as well as 10% on your profits. Now you can see that if you continue to stretch this out through your entire career, you can see what an insane snowball effect this would have. So now you can see how a Roth IRA will help you become a millionaire. Now, another thing that will help you become a millionaire is smashing that like button. That's right. Believe it or not, there are studies that show that if you smash the like button on my Silver Picker videos, you have a 10% greater chance of becoming a millionaire by age 60. Anyway, to show you how insane this is, let's take a look at two examples. Take you and your buddy. Let's say the two of you are 18 years old and your buddy is a responsible saver. He decides to put $6,000 away in a bank account every single year. When he retires in 41 and a half years at the ripe old age of 59 and a half, he will have saved $249,000. Wow, a quarter of a million bucks. But you are not just responsible, you are also smart. You decide to put that same $6,000 per year into a Roth IRA. Now, let's say the Roth IRA grows at a conservative rate of 6% per year on average, and your $6,000 per year will be worth $1,040,000. Yes, four times more than that of your friends. But it gets better. Imagine your investment grows at a rate of 8% annually, which, by the way, is the average growth of the S&P 500 since 1957. Your $6,000 per year will be worth $1,840,000. That's right, almost 2 million bucks. Your friend will have a quarter of a million dollars, which I might add is sadly more than most people will have when they retire, but you will be a bona fide millionaire. Yes, in addition to your other income, investments, savings, and assets, you will have a $2 million windfall when you retire. Now, there are still a few key things you need to know about the Roth IRA. First off, the younger you start, the better, and every single year matters. If you start at 18, you will have that cool 2 million bucks. But if you start at 30, that 2 million bucks will only be worth $661,000. Now, still better than your friend who also, if starting at 30, will have only saved $177,000, but nothing like that 2 million that you'd have if you start when you're 18.
So if that wasn't clear, start today.
The other benefit that you get from investing in a Roth IRA starting at a younger age is that you're likely in a lower tax bracket now than you will be in the future. Meaning this post-tax money that you're investing into your Roth IRA will have been taxed at a much, much lower rate today than if you were to, say, invest starting in 10, 20, or 30 years. Now, it's also important to remember that this is indeed a commitment. There is some degree of responsibility you have when you put money into a Roth IRA because any money that you earn on your contributions cannot be withdrawn without penalty until you're 59 and a half years old. Of course, you can always pull out your contributions up to that point without penalty, but if you pull out any money that you've earned on those contributions before you turn 59 and a half, you will be hit with fairly steep penalty fees, and you don't want that. Now, there's a flip side. You don't actually have to pull your money out at 59 and a half years old. You can let it ride for as long as you want. In fact, if we take our old example where we earned 8% interest from 18 years old until 59 and a half years old, where you earn $1.8 million, if you let that money ride till you're 65 years old, just a few years later, that $1.8 million becomes
$3 million.
Yes, you heard me right. 3 million bucks. You can't beat that. I mean, come on. So now we're up to the important part. How do you actually do it, right? Well, it's actually really simple. First, you open your investment account with a reputable brokerage firm, you put your money in, you choose your investments, buy your investments, and voila, you're on your way to becoming a millionaire. Personally, I use Fidelity for my Roth IRA, but there are plenty of other good brokerages to choose from. In fact, I've heard Vanguard is even better, so I'll put the link for those two down below, but you can use any one that you think fits your needs the best. So the big question you're probably asking yourself right now is, which investments should I actually include in my Roth IRA, right? Well, I can't tell you which specific investments to make because I don't know your personal financial situation, I don't know your risk tolerance, and it wouldn't be appropriate for me to offer that kind of advice without knowing you on an individual basis. However, I can share with you how I've broken down my IRA investments. So you can take a look on the screen and you can see how I've invested in my Roth IRA with Fidelity. There are comparable funds in all the different brokerages, so Vanguard, Charles Schwab, etc., and whichever one you decide to choose will have comparable options. However, the main thing that I would say to look at is look for funds that have a long-term track record of strong returns and as low management fees as possible. Those are the two golden rules you should look for when you're going to include any investment in your Roth IRA. Now, you may be wondering why you don't see gold or silver, given that I am, of course, the silver picker. Well, that's basically just because I care about diversification, and because I invest in gold and silver so heavily in my sort of non-retirement funds and investments, I don't want to also then double down on it in my retirement funds because I'm managing that portion with physical gold and silver on my own. So you may want to include gold and silver in your IRA, and that's totally up to you, but it's based on your own strategy and your own risk tolerance. Now, I hope you liked the video, and more important, I hope you learned something. And if you did, I'll ask you to do two things. One is hit that like button. Helps me out, I'd really appreciate it. But more important than that, share this video with your friends. Send it via email, post it on Facebook, send it via Instagram, whatever you gotta do to get the word out to your friends and family of how critically important it is to invest in a Roth IRA when you're young. If you wanna retire with your friends in style and you want to help your friends and family literally become millionaires by the time they retire, send them this video and set up your Roth IRA account today. Really, there's nothing better you can do for your future than setting up a Roth IRA account. Well, if you like this video and you want to see more personal finance videos that will help you sort of make a little bit of extra money on your own terms, let me know in the comments below and I'll keep making them. Maybe I'll do one a month. But if you did and you aren't a subscriber, hit the subscribe button as well. If you are a subscriber, of course, thank you so much for being part of the Silver Picker Squad. More videos on gold, silver, precious metals, coins, investing, hustles, and much, much more to help you earn a little bit of extra money. So I hope you enjoyed the video. There's a lot more great stuff coming down the pike. And until next time, Silver Picker out.